Hello friends and welcome to another tutorial on Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to cover the tree traversal techniques. In simple word, traversing a tree means to read or process the content of a tree node exactly once in some order. Now since tree is not a linear data structure like an array or a linked list where we have a logical start and a logical end, therefore, it can be traversed in many ways. We broadly classify traversing into two ways, the breadth-first traversal and the depth-first traversal. These techniques are a general way of traversing a graph, and since tree is a special form of graph, we can use them. Now, breadth-first traversal is also known as level-order traversal in trees. Depth first has further categories. It can be preorder traversal, inorder traversal, or a postorder traversal. We'll go through each of them one by one. First, let's have a look at breadth first traversal. In trees, we also call it as level order traversal. We have done a separate video on level order traversal, which is quite in depth, and you can refer to it. For now, understand it as follows. Level order traversal refers to traversing the tree nodes in a level by level fashion. Let's see it with an example. In this tree, if we start from node A, the order of traversal would be: first we visit this layer, then layer 2, then this layer, and finally the last layer 4. So our final order will look like this. Now we look into the depth first traversal. We divide it into three categories. First is the preorder traversal. In this, we first traverse the root, then left subtree, and then right subtree. Next we have inorder traversal. In this, we first traverse the left subtree, then we traverse the root data and then the right subtree. Then we have postorder traversal, where we first have left subtree, then right subtree, and finally the root data. Let's go through them one by one. First, we have the preorder traversal. This is the code snippet taken from Geeks for Geeks, and we'll follow this recursive algorithm. Let's also have a sample tree. We'll run our algorithm for this tree. Let's start from node A. Since it is not null, we print it and move to its left subtree. Since B is also not null, we print it and move to the left subtree of B. D is not null. We print it and move to its left, which is null, so we return and go to the right subtree, which is again null, so we return to B and check right subtree of B. E is not null. We print it and move to the left subtree of E, which is F. Again, left and right subtree of F are null, so we return to E and check its right subtree, which is also null. The control therefore passes to A. Since the left subtree of A has been traversed, we check the right subtree of A. C is not null. We print it, and since there are no left or right subtree of C, and with this, the recursion stops. Next, we have inorder traversal. In this, we first traverse the left subtree, then we traverse the root content, and then the right subtree. This will be the algorithm for inorder traversal with only a slight difference from the preorder one. We'll also use the same tree for demonstration. We begin with the node A. Since it is not null, we go to its left subtree. B is again not null. We go to its left subtree. D is again not null. We go to its left subtree, which is null. So we return to D. We now print D and go to its right. Since the right subtree is absent, we go back to B. Now, since left subtree of B has been traversed, we traverse or print this node B and go to its right subtree. We reach E. Since it is not null, we go to the left of E, which is F. And then, since left of F is null, we print it. And since right is also null, we move back to E. Now we print E and go to the right subtree of E, which is null. So we move back to B and then to A. Since we have traversed the left subtree of A, we can now print it. Now we move to the right subtree of A, and since left subtree of C is absent, we print it. There is no right subtree of C, and then our recursion stops. Next, we have the post order traversal. In this, we first traverse the left subtree, then we traverse the right subtree, and finally we traverse the root content. We have this algorithm for post order traversal. We'll use the same sample tree for demonstration. We start with root node A. Since it is not null, we go to its left subtree. We come to B. Now, since B is also not null, we go to its left subtree and reach D. D is also not null. We check its left, which is null, then its right, which is again null. Now we can print this node and move back to B. We will now traverse the right subtree of B. We come to E and go to its left subtree. We reach F. And since left and right of F are null, we print it. We move back to E, and since right is absent, we print this node E. We move to B, and since left and right subtree of B are covered, we can print it and move back to A. Now left subtree of A is over and we need to traverse its right subtree. We go to C. Its left and right are absent, so we can print it and move back to A. The left and right subtree of A has been traversed. So now we can print it too. We print it, and with this our recursion stops. Now we look at the complexity of the algorithm. All the algorithms finishes in linear time, and so the time complexity will be big O of n, where n are the number of nodes in our tree. With this, we come to end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment box below. Thanks for watching.